Hi, and welcome back to another Spatial Dip devlog. This week I've been working on this plug and cord mechanic. A player can pick up a plug, and then a cord will follow them. And the cord has a lot of good chord behaviors, like smoothing itself out, and it'll pick itself up as you backtrack. And it'll drape really nicely over other objects. And like the stuff from last video, this chord also behaves and scales according to beacons like the player. And once you plug it in, it'll solidify into one game object. I think the sense of scale is really neat with this one. Here you can see a little bit more of the physics of it as I jump off this thing. All the physics happens in the nodes that are dropped behind you, and they'll react to the previous node and the next node and to gravity, and they'll scale, and based off of all that they'll gain a scale and a position, and then segments will be placed and scaled between them. So here's a view of just the nodes, and you can see them kind of shifting, moving, deleting, and adapting to the environment. After a node is placed, it will calculate its physics, and then once it's still for a bit, it'll go into like a sleep mode where it only updates every few frames unless you place a beacon next to it, in which case it'll update immediately. I spent a lot of time doing these optimizations, and I got to the point where I could simulate 1,000 nodes and retain a pretty good frame rate. I'm able to get this hanging behavior by letting the nodes fall directly down and splitting up segments that are too long. Every time I split a segment, it'll create a node that is closer to being right below the previous node. Once that node is right below the previous one and a max distance away, then it'll enter an is-dangling state. The nodes that come after it can hang from that one and then also enter an is-dangling state all the way down. This was a really cool mechanic to program because you're basically just telling it a bunch of rules to follow, and then these weird emergent things come out of it. If they're not synergizing well or there's some error, you get some really weird behavior like this. Yeah, thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, then remember to like and subscribe. And if you'd like to support this project, you can find my Patreon link in the description. Special thanks to my current patrons, Ian Burns and Red Wolfenite. I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks.